I have here six rocks, all of which have a groove in the middle. And so I want to talk about what makes some of them netsinkers, axes, and mauls. Three different kinds of tools, but similar kinds of overall structure. So we can start with a simple netsinker. It's a rock that has a little groove carved in the middle in order to attach it to the bottom of a net, in order to weigh down the net so that people can go fishing. And it could be something that's very nicely rounded and polished. It can be any shape rock with some grooves on the side of it. It just needs to be able to hold a cord so that this can sink down and keep the bottom of the net suspended in the water. We move up from that, we've got axes, which people will usually recognize. This has a groove in the middle for hafting, so this would have been hafted on some sort of a stick. One end tends to be rounded. They might use this as a hammer, but the other end will be pointed. It'll have a bit for chopping as an axe. So one rounded end and one pointed end. These two are more unusual stones. We call these mauls, and these are stones that we think are being used not for chopping, but for crushing. They are very heavy, they've got a groove, and one end has an awful lot of pecking and battering where it's been used, and this isn't hafted, I'm just going to demonstrate, in some sort of hammering action such as that. These are found more commonly on the plains where there would have been bison hunting, and I'm not sure that we can demonstrate this, but I suspect these were used to crush bison bones. So you would have this hafted on something and you would be using this end for hammering. These are somewhat similar to what we see with the netsinkers, but they have heavy battering on either one or both ends, and they're much heavier than you would need for a net. And they're different from axes because they're rounded ends, not pointed ends. So mauls, axes, netsinkers, all stones with a groove in the middle, very different functions.